Now, June 21st marks the longest day of the year. This guy right here can explain that whole thing to
5:07
you.
5:07 in the morning, that's when the summer officially starts.
All I know is it's the summer solstice, but it's not just noteworthy to meteorologists.
That's right. The longest day is also important to anyone who is
aging,
right? Because it's an all-day effort to raise money for Alzheimer's research and prevention. Lori Pope is with the American Contract Bridge League, which puts together the longest day, and Richard Oshlag is a bridge player and caregiver for his wife, who has Alzheimer's, and also her birthday that we just were mentioning there. So happy birthday to her.
Okay, so the connection between bridge and Alzheimer's.
Well, so, and Richard can speak to this as a bridge player.
Because he's like, you're like a master,
yes.
master bridge player, right? Which is a card game for those
right.
of you who came up in the age of video games and have never heard of it. What's the research show, Richard?
It just appears that people who are engaged in mental activities, especially things like the card game of bridge, which is a puzzle-solving game of sorts,
right.
and also has a lot of social interaction, that it can help delay the onset of dementia.
You just brought up an important point, because let's say Sudoku, you can do that, and that's a puzzle that
right.
uses your brain, but that's isolating in
it
a
is.
Way. So it's the social combined?
Yeah, absolutely. My wife played bridge up until a year ago, and when she was first diagnosed, which is now 5 years ago, even till a year ago, it was obvious to me that her ability to get out and see people kept her more engaged and prolonged the time that we had together.
Awesome.
Lori, how do we put these two things together then, as far as becoming a fundraiser or getting awareness out?
Well, so we actually are an inaugural partner with the Alzheimer's Association for the longest day. Mm-hmm. We've been participating for the last 5 years.
The American Contract Bridge
yes,
League.
Yes, the American Contract right. Bridge League. And so there's such a tight correlation between playing bridge and the delay of Alzheimer's, as Richard has shared. And so it was kind of, there was no reason why we shouldn't support. Our members were passionate about it. And the longest day, the Alzheimer's Association wants you to do what you love and okay. fundraise to help support research.
So basically anyone who plays bridge can get their foursome together and play, and that helps?
Yes, there are, yes.
Or they can join a game? That's...
Yes, so there are clubs across the country. There are 3,000 bridge clubs in North America, and many of them are participating in the longest day.
Nice.
They'll have different events. A lot of them do silent auctions. They'll do bake sales, and it's a day of activities where they're playing bridge back to back to back, and then raising money to fund Alzheimer's research.
And awareness.
Exactly.
Okay, I don't play bridge. I have a basic idea and concept. Can I still participate? Do I go? And do they have like beginner's classes and get me started in
they
all this?
They do. And see, I'm a beginner bridge player myself. And so they have introductory classes. And what I found about bridge players is they are so passionate about their game
mm-hmm.
that they are going to do whatever they can to make sure you have a partner to play with, because it is a partnership between two
right.
people and make sure that you're in the right class.
So this was a baby boomer thing for years. I mean, my mother always belonged to a bridge group.
Right.
So is it coming back with the younger set? I mean, are they?
The Bridge League is working very hard to work with juniors. Lori can address that better, because I know we have a championship coming up in Atlanta this summer, and she's very much involved
yes.
with
so,
what
so,
we're doing for the young people.
So are your millennials getting into it?
Yes, we actually, every summer we have the Youth North American Bridge Championships, where
okay.
kids from really all over the world come to participate for and compete for scholarships. And then we also have Collegiate Bridge Bowl. So all spring, colleges have been competing online to receive travel stipends to come and participate in this competition.
Awesome.
And we have about $43,000 in scholarships that we'll be giving out over those two events.
People at home may not know, but we have, is it the world headquarters?
Yes.
So that's right here in town.
Well, yeah, we're actually the North American headquarters.
Right.
The ACBL, our member countries are U.S., Canada, Mexico, and Bermuda, and we are part of a worldwide place called the World Bridge Federation. They're headquartered in Europe.
It obviously does a lot for the brain. People like Bill Gates swear by the game.
Yeah, so yes. Bill Gates worked well for him.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Isn't
it? Bill Gates and Warren Buffett play
Warren
together
Buffett
all the time.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for sharing that information.
Thank
go
you.
Online to get additional. Thank
and
you.
And please tell your wife happy birthday.
I will definitely
right.
do that.